All right, we're going to show how to install a corner panel from the 9-panel kit. So basically, you need the 4 sensors it comes with. If you want the corner to still be raised compared to the left, right, up, down, you'll either need to have some washers like this or similar, or one of the riser frames. This is a Gen 1 frame, so it doesn't have 8 holes. It just has 4, but same concept. So, pretty easy. You're going to first remove the existing corner panel. I highly recommend these dedicated hex drivers. I think this is just a 4mm. Super easy to get the screws out. All right. There we go. Then mine has the window tint on the bottom, which I'll be swapping over. So normally your corner panels are gonna have little 4 washers in the corners. Those are just there from factory so that they're raised a little higher. You can use those 4 if you don't have the risers or whatever. But these, they're not as thick as the riser, so it's not gonna be raised as high as normal. So really the next thing you need to do if you're going to be putting on the riser or the washers is you need to remove the panel frame. So these are not hex screws, these are Phillips screws. So I really recommend just using a hand tool, at least to get them started so you don't strip them. And then I recommend magnetic so they can come out of the hole a lot easier. So they just do this 8 times. Then you can just carefully lift it up and you can take this opportunity to clean out all the hair and dust and whatever if you'd like. So if you're going to use the washers, what you need to do, basically put the washer over the hole where the panel, the frame screw is going in. You gotta put all 8 down. I'm just gonna put 4 just to kind of show you the idea. You could just use 4, it doesn't really matter that much. But then what you need to do is carefully set the frame down and make sure that the washers don't move because they have to be lined up with the holes. So what you could do now, you can just stick something down through the hole just to keep it aligned. Like it could be a screw, like a smaller screw or like a little screwdriver or something. But basically, then you're just gonna replace those screws in there. And that will keep it sturdy, and that will have it raised up so it has the raised corner. I'm gonna do the riser frame. Hopefully it fits because these are older risers. So to get the riser under there without undoing all the cords, you just put it over diagonally and kind of go around like that. And just line it up. Okay, so the holes line up. Now when you're putting the frame back in, you just be careful that these wires don't get in between the frame and the panel holder. You just want to be careful. Like right here on this side, the wire came up. You just gotta push it down and it keeps popping back up. So you might have to reach in through the little hole and kind of hold it down. So right now the riser is not lined up. None of the holes are lined up. This is a lot easier than moving individual washers. You just kind of push it from the side with like a screwdriver or whatever. Now all 4 are lined up. Then you just put the screws back in. If you have the newer, like current generation of risers, there'll be 8 holes that line up. In my case, there's only 4 because these are old risers from my Gen 1. So if you're using washers, definitely do not tighten the screws down until all 8 are in and started. So once you start tightening them, as you're rotating the screw, it might slightly move the frame and the other washers might get misaligned. So that's why it also helps to have something in the hole to keep the washer lined up before you actually put the screw in. That's why I recommend just using the risers. Like, way easier. Okay, and then once you get them all in there, just tighten them. Don't overdo it. Once you get snug, then go maybe like a quarter turn. Just needs to be like snug, not super tight. All right, we're almost done. Next thing is, if for some reason you had installed sensors in these before, you might have some residue from the adhesive on the sides. So just use some Goo Gone and a towel. Just spray onto the towel, not into the actual frame. But it doesn't take very much. You just a little bit, and then mostly you're just wiping. I tried using a microfiber towel the first time I did this, and the microfibers just get all clogged up with the goo, so just use a regular towel. And just go over it, double check that the adhesive is actually gone. Okay. Then use the dry part of the towel just to kind of get as much of the goo gone off as you can. Next step I do is I use some rubbing alcohol to get the goo gone residue off. Just take a paper towel, just some ISO. Basic. Really doesn't matter what percentage, because this isn't, you're not using it really on electronics, you're just cleaning. It just takes longer to evaporate with the lower percentages, that's all. That's it, it's clean. So the next step I'm doing is sensors. These sensors do come with the adhesive strips, and there's some paper tape covering them. I'm not going to use the adhesive, because that just makes it harder to troubleshoot. So one thing you'll notice is you just put the wires in straight in. The wire is like curved up above the plane of where the panel will be. So you can kind of just push the wire down. Just kind of bend it down. That's fine. Another thing you can do is before you plug it in, you can give this a twist. And then plug it in. And the twist basically just makes it do kind of a loop down before it gets to the plug-in part. All right, so they're all plugged in. Now you're taking your rubber corners and installing those. It's really easy when you don't use the adhesive, because you just line them up, push through the hole in the corner. And then that's it. Okay, that's pretty much it. And just now the sensors might be like slightly bowed up like this. That literally makes no difference. Okay. Then we have the new panel sitting here upside down, because I'm going to swap the window tint from the old panel to the new one. So the way I had the tint on there is I just had the corners with double-sided tape. I could probably just reuse it. Yep. Just putting it on there, the only thing you really need to make sure is that the film doesn't overlap with the foam on the side here at all. See, like right here, it's overlapping just a tiny bit. Okay. And here, let me show you with another one. So with the tint, you only need to cover this clear part in the middle. You don't need to cover all the way to the edge of the foam. Okay, so you basically just need like this portion covered. Because the rest of it's painted with black, so you're not going to see. Plus, you can see the LEDs. The PCB is only this big, so the light coming from the edges isn't even going to reach it anyways. Alright, so now I have this panel. I'm just putting it down. Just remember, anytime you're putting these kind of screws back in the panels, you want to check that this piece is screwed all the way up to the top. You don't want to have a gap like that. You don't want to have a gap at the top. So just screw that all the way up until it's tight up against the top. And then put all four in there and you're done. I usually don't tighten them all the way until I get to the last one. That just makes it so if they're slightly out of alignment, the panel will just move into alignment as you tighten it. And these really don't need to be that tight, just until it's just snug, and that's it. But yeah, and that's it. That's, you just do that four times and your stage is done. And if you have another stage, four more, and that's it. Easy. Thumbs up.